Yes, now blessed, now do not forget the rest. Now Dez at King of the Pit TV, at Dez Rocksteady on Instagram. Follow me, let's get talking music. I gotta treat these tool heads out there because you give me some good traffic. I'm not gonna lie, Tool has a decent fan base. Ian, some of you give me a bit of grief as well. Don't think I don't see that. So, Tool the Grudge, we've already done that video, yeah? So that's the first track on this record. We are doing the entire record, by the way, entitled, is it Lateralus? I believe that may be how it's pronounced. Who knows? But regardless, we're going to bypass the first track. I don't think I've heard any of the others. So we're going to start off with Aeon Blue Apocalypse, which seems like it may possibly be a bridge of some sorts. It's 1 minute, 6 seconds. Don't get guessed at any advertisements. We're all coming along for the same ride. Let's get stuck in. Tool. The entire record, King of the Pit TV. Never heard this before, alright? A very nice resolve there on the doom, 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 boom. Return nice to the root there, nice and clean and calm. Made me feel good inside. Going into summit now, the patient audio.
Your work can feel yes, much smoother Monday. With Monday.com Work
people.
OS.
Come on, people, Monday.com.
This smooth.
Oh, I knew Tool were prog of some sorts, but I didn't expect that. Good groove. It's like the ticking of a clock, in my opinion. Tick, tick, tock, tock, tick, tock, tick, tock. Slight hum of the vocal there. So far, I'm acknowledging the guitarist's tastes for pedals and effects. Nothing like super extra, but there's always some sort of additional bonus on them guitar tones. Gonna go back on that bit. I like the very subtle fade out of the instrument, and then that guitar got brought into the foreground nice and steady there. Almost as if there was a volume swell on that guitar, then I think it panned a little more. Tool fans, yeah, you're all a bunch of grunges. Yeah, you know, you lot are a bunch of grunges, mate. And once that bass guitar came in, nice higher register, really nice, to be fair. The way it weaves in and out with the guitar, Very tasty. Come on. It's almost at a higher register than the guitar. I've listened to two Tool tunes, yeah, and one of them was a live one. This is the first time I've heard them go proper distorted. Cute little harmonies there. Okay, right. I got lost. I got completely lost throughout that section. It started to muddle up. It was like a perfect muddle, right? All of the instrumentation were just weaving in and out like a spider's web, not making any sense, yet still forming a construct of sorts as we still continued moving forward. It felt like it was falling apart, but it never fell apart. That was really cool. I haven't spoken on the drummer yet, because I'm not a drummer, personally. But the way the drummer is accenting these bizarre beats of the bar, and there was a little flick of the snare, perhaps, at some point, or perhaps it was a tom. It was like almost a fill. And then there was... was it a crash cymbal? Just hitting the crash at just these most bizarre points, but they were accenting the right notes as to which the guitars were playing. And I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm finding this very hard to follow. What record label took this band and how did they blow up? And I ask that because this is a very niche sound, and for them to blow up to the degree they have done as far as develop this incredible cult fan base, someone in the industry had a vision, and I'm very interested to know the story of the beginnings of this band and how they got picked up. Ooh. just going to pause to say that was a groove. That still is a groove. Come on. Yo, the drummer was going crazy then on the tings and the tangs. Come on. Nice little falsetto there, almost. That's a falsetto, right? Keeping the vocal running underneath there. Wow, we're almost going into a radio rock sort of vibe. Yeah, I mean, no offense to this, because I'm not an expert on the genre, right? But I think they're a decent band, so don't take offense to it. But like a Nickelback sort of, yeah, I said that, like a Nickelback sort of cool, calm, clean rock vocal atop of a real nice, crunchy guitar and almost You Against the World style in your face chorusy section right now. Better percussion. Bassist jamming. Good use of dynamics. He's really brought it down. And then they went and slowed it down. Yeah, brilliant. Brilliant. We're listening to the entire record, so I'm not going to stop and talk for too long. But as far as that, a brilliant introduction to the record. I know I bypassed The Grudge because I heard that before, but I prefer this tune. This was brilliant. There was like a heavy groove, about three quarters in, more or less. That was brilliant. Really enjoyed that. I'm starting to understand there's a great dynamic. And even the slowing down at the end there shows great capabilities and thought, because most bands wouldn't do that for a start. And not only are we playing in these bizarre time signatures and making it work and these polyrhythmic sort of ideas, we're also messing around with the dynamic, and we're messing around with the fluctuation of tempos and so forth. So thumbs up. That was Tool the Patient. Right, let's get on to this next tune. Right, yesterday, this next tune is Lily was entitled wondering if she could Mantra, ever save enough for her and own it's gonna place. So today. Right, cool. Hold on. So this is Mantra, yeah? I assume it's another bridge sort of section into the next tune, which is called, is it Schism? Now, I've seen that name before, that Schism. That must be one of their more popular tunes, so I'm looking forward to getting into there. Without further ado, Tool, Lateralus, the full record. We're getting straight into it. Come on. Should have smoked a bifter before this one. Gonna hit a bit of chest later. Chest and tries, come on people. It's Sorry if I'm missing some deep meaning to this tune. Just a little bit of filler in it. A little bit of filler. Let's get onto the tune Schism, yeah? The one I've seen around before. I know it's going to be a good number. Or at least it should be. Let's get onto it. Come on. Are we going to get an advertisement? I bloody hope not. We've set the tone. We've set the tone. Almost like a bit of classical guitar. Healthy kids are happy kids, people. Is that the bass guitar? Yo, that little flick. What would you call that? A rake? Yo, dude, is that the bass guitar? That's tasty if that's the bass. Is that what it does? You're raking with the swingers. Great development of the dynamic with the guitar there. Slight palm mute into just a little, as with your power chords. There it is again. Building tension, it wants to go somewhere. All the band's gonna come in on this riff now. Yeah, right. Tool is for the people, yeah. Tool is for the people who feel satisfied when they can hum along to the riff. When they can finally hum along properly to the riff. What a satisfying band, right? It's like a puzzle in a band, isn't it? Drummer's grooving. A Rage Against the Machine-esque groove somewhat. I'm going back there. Did you hear the power in that accent there? Boom! It's like just a gleaming ray of light just firing through the clouds there. Oh, this sounds like the Money for Nothing tone. Ba, ba, da, 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 da. That's the way you do it. Oh, he's gonna start playing Money for Nothing. Now, there's been a lot of effects that come in and out of these tunes, and with it being such a guitar-centric act, well, you know, it's not a guitar-centric act because the drummer is pretty bold. Vocals are pretty bold, I'm sure, you know, for the non-instrumentalists in the room, the lyrical content is incredibly important and profound. But I feel that most of these effects that are coming in and out are produced by guitars as opposed to like synths and alike. Let me know how much the keys are actually involved in this band. Like such as that, I could assume that's a guitar, even though it sounds like a synth. One thing this band has a knack with is tone. Very blissful, very pleasing to the ears, that vocal. Build up. Come on. Seeping in there. I know the pieces fit. That sums up some of my experience listening to this. They have the pieces and they make them fit. It doesn't sound too disjointed. It doesn't sound too abnormal. I'd be happy to be in a crowd and bob my head and not feel like a complete idiot. Like, if I went and saw Meshuggah or some like super like egocentric time signature wankfest, I'd feel like an idiot trying to even move my body along to the music. But with this band, regardless of the signatures, I'm still able to be involved, and that's incredible. As a potential consumer, a clientele of the act, it's really important that I can feel accepted. So that's really good. Really good. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. That was a title I see reoccurring before even messing around with this channel. When I've seen Tool, I've seen this track mentioned, Schism. Where I've seen it before, I've no idea, but I've seen it a lot. That was really good. Like I said, I felt I could follow it to some degree, even though it's very abnormal. living in a world of 4-4 timing, which I do, which a lot of us do, but me in particular, I never leave 4-4 because I love it. It's good enough for me. I like the simplicity. This stuff is completely abnormal to my brain, and still, it sounds right. It sounds right, and that's really cool. I'm hearing influences, world influences outside of the Western world. I can't tell you where because I'm very naive to it all, but there's definite, you know, ideas that stem across the world, which I am unfamiliar with. Another mention would be the production of this record. It creates a bizarre sort of pullback with the drums in particular, I'm thinking, because listening to some parts, it sounds like in the studio that drummer was really going for it, really beating away and really creating a heavy racket and really smashing the drums. But on the record, the audacity of it is sort of dialed down. Whereas at first listen, I kind of assumed that the drummer was laid back and really just tapping away as opposed to beating. And I know that dynamically speaking, there's a broad range of dynamic and the drummer does do that. But even when it comes to the extra bits where he needs a bit of oomph and a bit of gusto, it still feels down to the production magic that he's sort of in the background, just still not necessarily being this, you know, ridiculous metal-esque drummer. I hope that made sense, because, you know, as far as production goes, it's quite hard for me to explain, but that was brilliant. That was Tool Schism. I'm enjoying going through this record. We're going to get straight onto the next one. Are we going to have another filler, or are we going to get straight into it? Let's see.
Your work can feel much smoother with Monday.com WorkOS.
Parable.
This smooth.
Nice. 3 minutes long. I like a 3 minute long track. Let's get onto it. King of the Pit TV, Dez at Dez Rocksteady. We're listening to Tool. The entire record, this tune is entitled Parable. Never heard it before. You heard that dong, dong, operating at a lower meditative frequency. Which is brilliant to have a drone at that frequency. It's not something a band does regular but should do. Almost like a prayer. Could somebody tell me what it's called when a drummer is to rattle the cymbals and have that sort of chain of effect? Because in the last video I spoke of, or the last song, I spoke of how the drummer seems like on the record is pulled back to an extent where the audacity is sucked from the playing, and there's an emphasis on how they actually contribute, as opposed to here's a wall of sound, the drummer is mighty and mega. It's more so this is what the drummer is contributing, and this is how the drummer is really forming their piece of the sound. That drummer sounds like he's miles away when he's doing the cymbals right there, and that's really nice. I find it very pleasurable, the panning and the sort of depth of sound that is created in this band so far. The producer should get some props. Maybe it's a member of the band, but... This band's got Middle Eastern influences. That didgeridoo. Yo. Yo, mind my ignorance, it probably isn't. Right, this is another odd thing to sort of throw into the mix, but this band is so alien and conjures up so many odd thoughts that I feel it's necessary to mention them because I don't have these experiences often. But the vocal line here sounds somewhere between like a Middle Eastern sort of... I don't want to delve into religious speak because I'm not going to sound great doing so, because I don't know much, in all honesty. But, you know, it sounds almost prayer-esque. And also sounds like a 2000s female-fronted pop tune. It sounds like a Shakira sort of line. And it also sounds grunge. It sounds very grunge as well. Very cool, very cool, very cool. Where we're going. Oh, that was the end. Yo, we just had a volume swell. I said enough what needed to be said. Eh, we're going from parabol to parabol. Yo, I just heard a volume. Let's get straight into it. King of the Pit TV.
You get a free spin with a chance to win cash prizes.
You're listening to Dez at Dez Rocksteady. We're listening to Tool's record, Lateralus, for the very first time. Hello, I'm down here, people.
So no matter how
celebrate good times, great tune, cool in the gas.
With Paddy Power Games.
Yo, let's get straight into it. Come on. Yo, yes now, blessed now, King of the Pit TV. My camera just died as I was recording that. Just got into the start of this tune. All I'm saying is, straight away, this might be the best tune on the record so far, in my opinion. Let's get straight into it. Choosing to be here. don't mind the tuning. You heard that drummer just come in with the drive there. This is a straight up rock tune, mate. Honestly, just that drive there. Come on. The blend between the almost dreary vocal atop of this riffage from the guitar and this straight up ZZ Top driving drumming. Oh, it's definitely not a recipe for disaster. It's a recipe for just, yo, it's recipe for a foot tapper, mate. Bass guitar grinding that riff right there. Them harmonies are brilliant. So have you noticed Tool, right? They tend to have the main idea. Now, they may have a little bit of a build-up as far as the instrumental goes. They might bring an instrument in or out during the process, but they have one block, one section of this main idea. From there, they'll have like this little quarter block of middle ground before going back into the big block of, you know, whatever section came first. Then they'll go back into the little block, and then we move on to the next section. We keep it fresh. We break the pattern because our minds, as far as songs go, are built and prepared to create patterns. If we've heard it twice, we're going to hear it a third time. But when the songwriter doesn't give us it that third time and switches it up with something completely new, it adds more impact, all right? Why pop songs have bridge sections after the second chorus. Alright, we're showing off with a little time signature now. Incorporating the slide in there. Dun, 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 dun. Brilliant, brilliant. Drummer just peppered that snare with that fill right there. Let's go back to listen to that. Almost like a drum solo, that. Almost Rage Against the Machine-esque of a riff. verging on a heavy metal riff. Ooh, that's a hook. Come on. This band can go from sounding like a Rage Against the Machine act to ZZ Top to what now I would consider either some fuzzy stoner band or like some straight up drone. What is going on? Little natural harmonic there to finish off. Almost hypnotic, that last little section when it went clean there. Because the dynamic and the volume came down to such a degree that you have to listen. It's not there on autopilot. You have to pay attention when that happens. If you want somebody to listen to you, you don't raise your voice. You can also whisper, because they have to pay focus and attention as to what you are saying. So in the musical term, I'm sure it's just the same. I know I just had to do that. It's actually lowered my output. If you hear my voice right now in comparison to when I was gassed initially, it's actually calmed me down that extra little bit. It's almost like warming down after a workout. That was really good. That was my favourite off of the record. The first half in particular was brilliant for me. Absolutely brilliant, alright? That was Tool with Parabola, is it? We're listening to the full record, Lateralus. Let's get straight on to the next. What's next? An advertisement, perhaps?
Thank you, Mrs. Peters.
You get a free spin with a chance to win cash prizes every single day.
And then we've got Ticks and Leeches.
Do you think I'll end up looking like my mum?
I hope so.
Is it right that I should be targeted with gambling advertising?
So no matter how badly you stuff
I
it
don't
up,
think so.
Get more chances with Paddy Power Games.
Right. You know who it is. We're getting stuck straight in. We're listening to the entire record. Tool. Lateralus. This tune is entitled Ticks and Leeches. Of course, I've never heard it before in my life. Let's get straight into it. That last tune was a banger. If this can compete, I'm going to be surprised. It's like a battle drum. It feels as if we're storming into battle with an opposing army. Also gives me rainforest vibes for some reason. Like quite a primitive beating on the drum there. Very tribal-esque. Very tasty. The drummer's going crazy and that riff. band has got so many influences and expresses them in such a whole variety of ways. The last two tunes have been pretty heavy, man, in comparison to the first set of songs we've listened to. Yeah, I don't mean to annoy you, but this sounds verging on sort of like a nu metal style vibe, you know? I'm gonna be offensive here. I'll say it's quite corny. Quite corny. Yo, we're getting a rewind on this riff. Oh! Come on. Oh, that is a groove. Yo, when they kick into a groove like that, that to me, that's peak Tool. From what I've heard, that's my favourite aspect to this band. Very dreamy soundscape. It's like I'm sailing on a little boat across a dark and murky swamp. But nothing's bad. Nothing bad is happening. We're just sailing along with the moon lighting our way. Very pleasant guitars. Oh, they're dragging it a bit. I'd like them to drag it a bit longer. This is wonderful. Oh, click like and click, well, leave a comment if you're a pothead, yeah, and you listen to Tool. I don't smoke, but if you do, let me know, yeah, because I bet this is heaven. Little subliminal vocal in the back. I wonder where this is going. Because Opeth do this. They drag a nice acoustic and bring it into something tasty. Obviously, it's not acoustic, but it's clean, right? Unless this continues until the end of the track, which would be interesting. We've gone through an incredible dynamic with the band so far. Tom's giving a little warm up there. Come on. I bet that scared so many people first time listening to this. Suck me dry. Ticks and leeches, makes sense, right? Sounds like John Brannan from Negative Approach. If you're a Tool fan and you haven't listened to Negative Approach before, which I'm sure most of you haven't, it's a hardcore punk band. But they're one of the best hardcore punk bands that has ever been and will ever be. So check him out. Negative Approach, yeah. Vocals sound like this. Right, that was edgy. That was pretty metal. That was pretty metal. That was Tool, Ticks and Leeches, everybody. Wow. Without further ado, we're gonna go into the next track. I'm curious what I'm gonna listen. So we've had two, let's call them hard rock tunes, okay? And the start of this record was relatively clean. Where are we going next? Where are we going next? I don't think we've got another heavy one. I don't think we've got another distorted one. But this one is the title track. Correct me if I'm wrong, is it Lateralus? Okay, because if it's not that, I've been saying it wrong the entire time. This is the title track,
your
people.
Your work can feel much smoother with Monday.com WorkOS.
Monday.com.
This...
They're not paying me, by the way. 17 million views. This is the one people listen to the most, I think. We're in for a ride, 9 minutes. King of the Pit TV. Dez, first time listening to Tool. Lateralus, the full record. This one is Lateralus, the title track. At Dez Rocksteady on Instagram. Follow me, let's talk music. Oh, it's like a heartbeat in the background. It makes me cringe that I don't like the sound of heartbeats. It makes me feel very uncomfortable. Yo, frontman's definitely tried DMT before. If this guy's never had DMT, the whole band's a lie. I'm not gonna lie to you. Yes, now Black Sabbath. All right, so from track 7, this record has turned into a hard rock band. And I like it. I prefer it. I like this a lot. Wow. Very hard to follow. First time I'm really going to comment on the lyric. The lyrical to this is really good. I'm sure there's an alternate meaning to the simplicity I'm sort of making out of the lyrics. I'm assuming he's speaking biologically. I don't know as to what your eye conjures up first as far as the colour spectrum, but maybe it's something to do with that. Maybe it's down. Maybe it's like just judging by the artwork and stuff. Maybe it's regarding a trip of such. I don't really know what the concept is, but what I'm making out of it and what I'm hearing as far as the way the words are presented and phrased, really enjoying this lyric, really enjoying this lyric. That lead guitar reminds me a little bit of Porcupine Tree. It's gonna be a beat down. A brilliant aspect of the production and what the band does is that even when using clean guitars, even in contrast of like distortion and you know, a more fuller instrumental, everything has space and everything comes at you with a clarity and a value as to which you can just hear the finest subtleties within that instrument being played, and that's really cool. This band uses every step in the dynamic spectrum to create a fantastic range of sound and idea. It's not you have a clean section and you have a distorted section. You have clean, you have another clean, you have another clean, you have an overdriven, you have a sharp overdriven, you have all these wealth of different tonalities and effects in between, and then you might put your foot down on the distortion, but what sort of distortion? It's really incredible, you know. So when you're building up, you're thinking, oh, it's going to kick you in the face, but it might be building up to this lightly coated overdriven section as opposed to this rock and roll number, and you never know what's around the corner. And it's, I'm speaking in regards to myself when I say you might be expecting like this overdriven hard rock sort of aspect, when that's not what's coming, because it's such a, what do you call it, a breath of fresh air as opposed to the standard. Because I thought, oh, my brain thinks it knows it all. And it thinks it can just understand and assume what's coming next. Because why not? It's a band, right? Of course they're going to do that. That'll be the right thing to do. But that's not the case. This band redefines the direction of the piece. And it keeps it interesting. It's really good. We've got a solo. How that drummer and that bassist is just jamming together. I bet being in that band and pulling this off and being tight about it is one of the best feelings in the world.
Myself, it's
perfect cadence at the end. You love to hear it, perfect cadence. All of that just came together right there at the end with that cadence. Incredible, that was really good. One thing I haven't had a chance to comment on yet is I think my favourite part of that last section is the bass guitar. Boom, 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 just sliding on every note. And then the sort of like what should feel like a straightforward section came in, the vocals, the riff, the drums, but that bass guitar continues doing that and just muddles the whole thing up, just goes out of the way to muddle it up. Yeah, really good. That was the title tag, Tool, Lateralus. We're listening to the entire record. That's Dez at King of the Pit TV, at Dez Rocksteady on Instagram. Let's talk music. Let's go. Yes, now, bless now, people. Do not forget the rest now. Dez at King of the Pit TV, at Dez Rocksteady on Instagram. Let's talk music. First time listening to Tool's entire record, Lateralus. We're currently on track number 10. This is entitled Disposition. 4 minutes 47. Without further ado, let's get on to it, see what he's saying. One love. A lot of time to shine for the bassist in this band, which is always pleasant. You know what it is? Emerge impact, catch a cheap buzz. Quite a fan of natural harmonics, this band, or at least the guitarist. Is this a four-piece band, or is it a five-piece? Because they could pull off four-piece. Guitar, scale, chords, whatever you would want to call it, is a real angelic, almost melancholic soundscape. I don't want to use the term soundscape, but I don't know. I need to read a dictionary because I don't know how to describe it. But it's incredibly pleasing on the ear. It is melancholic because it's not a negative frequency, but it's, I don't know, there's an air of nostalgia for me listening to this guitar section.
Thank you.
quite an experimental track. It's not an interlude, but I could consider this an interlude, because we're sort of riffing on just the one idea. There's not necessarily any movement within the track as far as sections go. You know, we're bringing things in and out, and we've got a few different lead parts and so on and so forth, but with the minimalistic lyrical and with us just sort of forming around this one idea, almost like a jam, almost makes me think that they've conjured this up at band practice or something alike. Very light acoustic guitar there in the background. I just had a little run. Do 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 do. There are the natural harmonics there as well, twinkling in the background. Watch the weather change. They use the strings right, they don't use the strings like your average composer or act. They use the strings in a much deeper sense, as to where, yeah, they are hitting notes, but they're using the instrument to really blend into the mix as opposed to stand alone and show off. Each one of the instruments really interacts. And to be honest, we're 10 tracks into this record now, and I can see why I annoyed a couple of people. I ruffled a few feathers when the first experience I had was watching the live performance of Sober, and I didn't get it, but I can see why Tool fans are serious, because there's a lot of depth to this band, there's a lot of depth to the music. Whether you want to sort of make up your own sort of, you know, reasonings or not, because, you know, you could sort of project your own intellect onto this band, definitely, as opposed to just approaching it like, well, it's just a band that just create music, right? But they are different, and they are a band that is more than happy to play clean and fragile and integrate with one another in this blend that you don't hear often, not on a consistent basis like what I've heard so far. So that was me listening to Till Disposition. It's been an enjoyable ride so far. I'm listening to the entire record, Lateralus, is that it? I'm never gonna get it right, all in one. So let's go on with the next track, let's see what the deal is. Quite a long one, this next one, I think. Of course, we've got an advertisement.
Your work can feel much smoother with Monday.com Work OS. This smooth.
They're spamming me with that Monday.com. So this is Reflection by Tool. First time listening to it, yeah. Dez, King of the Pit TV at Dez Rocksteady. Let's get straight into it. Track number 11. One mention is that this drummer uses toms, or utilizes the toms, more than a lot of drummers I'm aware of. Really likes fooling around on them toms, probably because of the resonance it provides. This band is a big fan of like resonance and, you know, really utilizing particular frequencies to a level I can't explain, but I can hear through the music. They know what they're doing and they know what they want to imply through that. Thank you. I just hit 50 subscribers right now at this moment. We're going to check out. Let me know what I'm at when you watch this video. All right, 50 subs. Thank you very much, everyone. Tool are very interesting because they do the whole time signature thing and they jam out on like bizarre time signatures, right? But they still have a sound to them. It's still a tool sort of tone to the guitars and the riff. I've not heard a positive major upbeat sounding Tool riff whilst they've been using these time signatures. They've always seemed to be playing within this particular zone, which just results in them sounding like Tool. They definitely have a sound to them. They have a dynamic to them whilst they're playing within that space. And that's cool, because initially I started listening and I thought, oh, the Tool sound is the time signatures they use and how they use them. But there's a lot more to that. It's not only the time signatures, it's the actual way they are performing whilst playing in that time signature. Because they could use these time signatures and chug away, or, you know, twinkle away, or do this and that, but they use this. I don't want to say they've boxed themselves in regarding this, but they definitely have an on-brand sort of sound. At least in this record, perhaps. This sounds like the soundtrack to a time lapse of someone making an incredible journey through night and day, through like an Aztec environment, or just a incredible spiritual journey from A to B. And this music and this consistency, this repetition is creating the imagery of the time lapse of this individual's journey. This tune's called Reflection. 3.7 million views. It's a really nice melody on the vocals. The melody, very pleasing to me. Really good. Yeah. that guitarist is jamming out. Very intricate on the guitar there. Incredible dynamic. The vocal comes in, the instruments pull out, we're just left with the drums. Here we go. Instrumentally, it sounds like we're wanting to reach somewhere. From the start, there's been this ridiculous tension that wants to resolve somewhere, and I'm wondering, is it going to resolve? How is it going to resolve? Is it going to be rendered unfinished by the end? Is the next track going to resolve it? Or are we going to find a resolve within this actual piece right now? What an incredible set of minds. A beautiful thing regarding successful bands is how each member of the band, you know, there's going to be a weak link to the chain, so to speak, but the entire band come together with a common goal to create this sound and do it so well and so consistently and hopefully hang around enough to become incredible, famous artists. Each member of Tool has to agree that this is the sound they want and this is what they get along onto, because I've spent enough time with musicians to understand that if they end up pursuing somebody else's artistic endeavor that doesn't speak to them, it's not long before they start slacking, or not long before they're gone and they need replacing. So bands that have longevity and come together and agree on doing stuff, especially something as niche as this, that's brilliant. That's a brilliant politic. That's really good. we had to find We're All One Mind. A little bit of Carl Jung there. Like just one crazy 10-minute build up. It took you on a journey, didn't it? The imagery I got given was a journey when I was thinking about what this music could represent. And musically speaking, what I have experienced indirectly was a journey just then, and I've only just realized it. That was entitled Reflection. Fantastic. So you're listening to Dez at King of the Pit TV. That was Tool, Reflection. We're listening to the entire record. Let's get straight onto this next number and see what we think. We've got two tunes left. Yes, Now, Bless Now. Don't forget the rest now. Dez, King of the Pit TV, signing in once again. We are finishing off the entire record. We've been listening to Tool, Lateralus. This Tool tune is entitled Triad. At Dez Rocksteady on Instagram. Let's talk music. Come on, let's get straight into it. Oh, it sounded like a metal number. That sounded like a baby crying, but in complete tune. This is another primitive sort of number. Like the beating of some degree of percussive instrument, or like a war chant sort of situation I've got going on right now. Thank you. almost machine-like in a way. The way the background, the instrumental, just the cogs keep turning. And you hear these almost electronic, almost machine-like whirs and clunks and blips. But, you know, given the imagery I see before me on the album artwork, it can also represent the machinery as to what exists within us, perhaps. Call Tool a prog band. I've heard a lot of more modern prog bands that have had sounds like this, well, I've had tracks like this. Definitely modern prog. I haven't heard many old school acts that have a sound like this, or, you know, I think it's the distortion thing more than anything, but are Tool a prog band, because a lot of their sound is beyond prog to me. It's sort of like in a realm of its own. I just can't put my finger on what it is. Wow, that dynamic shift right there. I thought it was gonna get louder. Some maths going on with that drummer right now. Polyrhythm Central. Dude, this is one of the more technical aspects I've heard from this entire record. Wow, double kick there. Wow, they've really saved this until the end of the record. Like, this is crazy. And the machine continues on. Wow, we're on to the last track now, people. We're on to the last track now. That was Tool Triad. Yeah, I'm excited. We're about to polish this off. I've not listened to a record of this length in so long. This has been a journey and a half. Right, let's get straight on to it.
Play Paddy's Wonder Wheel for a free chance to win cash prizes again. Every single day. Paddy Power Games.
Terrible. Okay. I'm not going to try to pronounce the name of this tune, but you're listening to Dez at King of the Pit TV. At Dez Rocksteady on Instagram. Let's talk music. This is Tool. We've just finished the entire record for the first time ever. Lateralus, let's go. It's gonna be an outro, isn't it? It's almost spooky. It's like the clapping of thunder, but it's a drum kit. There's a high register whir in the top, which I find very spooky, man. Don't say we're talking about aliens right at the end. Don't tell me this record was an alien thing. Extra-dimensional beings, bro. I thought this was a spiritual thing. This is, yo, why are we talking about aliens right now? And I think I missed the point.
The space program made contact with. They are not what they claim to be. They infiltrated a lot of
of course the government knows. Not gonna lie, it gave me shivers there where it just blipped out. How was that for a swell? Wow. Right, I've just listened to the entire record, Tool Lateralis. It was you lot who made me do that. Because when I put a Tool video out here, I get some great insight and I also get a couple of people nipping me, yeah? So this one was for you lot, alright? Checked out the entire record, you can't go wrong with that, can you? So thank you for watching. I'm signing out, people. What Tool record should I put on next? Dez at King of the Pit TV. You know who it is. I'm signing out. That was Tool Lateralis, the entire